Hey, I'd like to welcome you to another episode of the Mission Matters Money Podcast, your source for all things money. My name is Adam Torres. You can follow me on Instagram at AskAdamTorres to keep up with my book releases, book tour schedule, signings, all that other good stuff. Always love to connect with you there. And as always, if you'd like to apply to become a co-author of one of my upcoming books, just head on over to the website, missionmatters.com, and click on Become an Author to apply. All right, so today I have Todd Sulzinger on the line, and he's president over at Blue Elm Investments. Todd, welcome to the show.
Thanks a lot for having me, Adam. I really enjoy your podcast.
So excited to have you on the show today. So not too often I get to talk about mobile home park and syndications, a very niche market. Excited to bring some of your knowledge and expertise to my audience. So let's just start kick it off with you telling us more about Blue Elm Investments.
Sure. Yeah, thanks. It is a niche investment. More people are finding out about it now, it seems like, over the last few years, but it's still a little bit under the radar. And essentially what my company does is I go out and source and acquire mobile home parks, and I raise money from investors to allow them to diversify their portfolio outside of typical Wall Street investments, so they get to share in some of the benefits of real estate investing. But I go out there and find the deals, put them together, and manage them. And kind of it's a great combination, I think, because it allows investors to invest passively to get some of those benefits of real estate investing, but it's also really creating a lot of affordable housing across the U.S. There's thousands of mobile home parks out there across the country with vacant lots or vacant homes, and one of our missions at Blue Elm is to try to add to the stock of affordable housing by rehabbing parks across the country.
No, I love it. I think it's a great service, but I think there's also some great, it's a great niche, great margins. I mean, because traditionally, and this has changed a little bit, I think, in the lending space, but it's been really hard for people to finance and to, like, get loans to improve these types of properties. So it's always just taken, like, outside capital. Am I off on that, or can you give us a little bit more on the background of the demographic?
That is still true. The lending space has opened up, and some of the larger lenders, some of the bigger banks, even like Wells Fargo and Bank of America, mm-hmm. when you get loan size above $1 million in that range, then you can get financing through them. There are some other lenders out there who I wouldn't say necessarily specialize in the space, but do have a fair amount of their loan portfolio in the mobile home park space. And typically your loan to values are going to be a little bit lower, so a little bit larger down payments, but there is the lending market has opened up in that space. Because it's not as expansive as in apartments or single-family homes, there is a greater ability to get seller financing. So some of the parks that I've acquired, I have had the sellers carry back notes, which is it's great. It makes for a quicker close. They get some of the benefits of not taking as big capital gain hit, as well as getting having income from the notes they're carrying back. And it just, again, can make the process from closing go a little bit smoother when you're not having to deal with inspections and appraisals that you would have to do with bank financing.
Yeah, and you're also, on your end, you're not necessarily, like with some of the larger multi-family housing and stuff like that, you're not, as of this point, correct me if I'm wrong, by the way, because I could be, you're not really competing with, like, the hedge funds or the institutional money. They're not, as of this point, going after these assets that heavily. Am I right or am I off?
It depends on the size. They have gotten a lot more into this. There's three big public companies that are in the mobile home park space, and they're typically at more of the higher end of the mobile home park world with kind of nicer amenities, maybe all senior parks on the West Coast and the East Coast. But there are some hedge funds that are finding this space interesting, and they're looking at parks that are larger than the ones I'm looking at. I'm looking at parks between the sort of 50 and 150 space range. Some of the hedge funds are coming in and looking at portfolios with parks that are 200 and above, or they're buying three or four parks worth from sellers that are 200 spaces and above. So there is competition at kind of the larger higher end, but there hasn't been that much competition, the sort of 50 to 150 space parks that I've been looking at.
So demographic, and I know this is going to change, but for some of the sellers out there, am I wrong that, I mean, are a lot of them, especially because you're doing, you know, some of them are offering seller financing, my guess is because, you know, let's just say the smaller investors that are going out there and picking up, you know, your 20-unit apartment complex or 30 or whatever, even larger than that, whatever, they're not necessarily looking in the space. So a lot of these sellers maybe have owned these parks for a really long time, mm-hmm. and they're looking to retire, or they're just looking at, and they're looking at what, how they're going to spend the retirement. They, you know, they already put in their dues, and now they want to cash out. Is that something that you kind of see along the way, or what? I'm just trying to get a feel for the demographic sellers out there.
Yes. I mean, they call it kind of these mom and pop operators. So
yeah, exactly.
Very true. They might own like a park, maybe a couple. They might have bought it from somebody early on in the 50s and 60s. They may have developed it themselves. Sometimes they may have lived on the park. And what that causes over time is they're often not as professionally managed as you might find apartments. So again, mm-hmm. it could be because they live on the park, they're friends with everybody. They may not really have kept rents up with what like the quote market would be. Mm-hmm. And so that's kind of where there's a lot of upside for my company when they can come in and buy a park from a seller that's not, again, you would say didn't really run it as professionally as maybe somebody mm-hmm. that ran a similar size apartment building. And yeah, true, they're just kind of looking to get out and move on with their life. The most recent park that I acquired in Tennessee, it was an 84-year-old woman. She owned quite a few other properties in this town, and for her, she was done with it. She was neglecting the park. It was just kind of a headache for her, and she was ready to move on. So you do find that, definitely do find that more in the mobile home park world than you would in the apartment space.
Yeah, no, I kind of figured that. So for the investors listening, I mean, why invest in mobile parks versus other assets? I mean, what are some of the pros that you found?
One of the main things I really like is it's a recession-resistant asset. So there's always going to be a need for affordable housing across the country. So as you see a lot of the development in the apartment space, a lot of times it's in the A class, much nicer apartments. And when we kind of hit the next economic hiccup that's, you know, going to come eventually, then those people tend to, if they're looking for a less affordable place or more affordable place to live, they'll kind of move down a step. And mobile home parks, when you compare them to apartments in a lot of markets, could be between $100 to $300 less per month for a place to live that's actually oftentimes bigger than an apartment. And it's nicer because they can drive right up, it's single story, they don't have anybody living on either side of them or above them or below them. So it does have a tendency to be more recession resistant just because of the overall need for affordable housing across the country. The other kind of cool thing about the mobile home park space is that there's rarely new parks being built. So if anything, new parks are being torn down for either redevelopment or just neglect, they might close down, but municipalities rarely allow zoning for new mobile home parks. So it's really the only asset class that there's fewer and fewer of every year compared to single family homes or apartments that are being, where there's new ones being built every year.
No, that makes a lot of sense. So Todd, if somebody is listening to this and they want more information on Blue Elm Investment or to connect, what's the best route for them to reach out?
Yeah, well, please go to my website. It's www.blueelminvestments.com. They can email me at todd@blueelminvestments.com. And I'd love to chat about real estate, investing, mobile home parks in particular, and I really want to have a big focus on educating investors on trying to pull some of the money out of Wall Street and get it into real estate, which are just great cash flowing, tax advantaged investments.
Fantastic. Well, hey, Todd, really appreciate you coming on the show today and educating us more on what's going on in the world of a mobile home park syndication and all the great work you're doing for all your clients and tenants, of course, and investors. And to the audience, as always, thank you for tuning in. Hope you got a lot of value out of this. If you did, don't forget to subscribe to the podcast. Leave me a review. If you're watching this on our YouTube channel, Mission Matters Money, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, but also leave us some comments in the comment section. Let us know what you're investing in. If you have any experience with mobile home parks or anything else, I'd love to continue the conversation there. And Todd, thanks again for coming on the show.